In this demonstration, you'll see how easy it is to use the Ansible modules for Dell VxRail to automate operations using the VxRail API. VxRail Ansible modules are available publicly from the standard code repositories such as Ansible Galaxy and GitHub. I highly recommend exploring the repository on GitHub shown here, as it contains the latest available version and the official product documentation and playbook examples, which you can easily clone to your environment and adjust as needed. These modules are well suited for infrastructure as code use cases. They are written in such a way that all requests are idempotent and hence fault tolerant. This means that the result of a successfully performed request is independent of the number of times it is executed. These modules are maintained by Dell, and we're introducing new functionality over time. We are also reducing the risk for customers who are adopting them in their environment. The community support model allows you to interact with a global community of experts. In our environment, we have a VxRail cluster consisting of three nodes. In this demo, we'll expand it with an additional node using the Ansible modules for VxRail. We also have a Linux-based automation server with Ansible installed. We can verify that with the ansible --version command. Let's have a look at the sample playbook for cluster expansion. Ansible playbooks are written in YAML, therefore using the correct structure and formatting is essential to avoid errors. We're going to execute this playbook on the local Ansible server. Note that we exported these sensitive variables, such as passwords, into a separate encrypted vault file called sensitive-vars.yml, which is a best practice for production environment. In the vars section, we provide the necessary parameters for the cluster expansion module, such as authentication to the VxRail manager server and configuration of the newly added node. The new node is selected using the host PSNT identifier, and you can check the list of available nodes with another module in advance. The collection section includes dellemc.vxrail, which contains Ansible modules for VxRail. In the task section, we call the dellemc VxRail cluster expansion module with the parameters defined above. Then we monitor the status of this asynchronous job in a loop until it's finished. Finally, we display the added node PSNT identifier and cluster expansion job result. When we check the contents of the sensitive vars file, we can verify that it is encrypted. We're using the Ansible Vault feature, which allows you to keep sensitive data such as passwords in encrypted files rather than plain text in playbooks or roles. Let's execute this playbook using the ansible-playbook command. Additionally, we're adding the --askVaultPass parameter to provide a password needed to decrypt the contents of the sensitive vars file that contains the passwords. We can see that the expansion job has been started, and we're monitoring the progress in the loop. We are switching to the vSphere client to see the effect of running the expansion playbook from the VxRail management interface. For your convenience, we're accelerating the playback in this part. What's interesting about the VxRail Ansible modules that we provide, in comparison to using just the Ansible built-in URI module, is that we are automating holistic workflows, which may require executing multiple API functions and looping and querying for the result of the asynchronous operations. And you can see it in this demo. We also provide better error handling and idempotency. In a few minutes, you can see the cluster reconfiguration tasks in the recent tasks pane. These are executed by the VxRail Manager built-in automation. After a few minutes, the newly added node is taken out of maintenance mode. In the console of our Ansible automation server, we can verify that the expansion playbook was executed successfully. We can confirm that the new node is operational in the vSphere client as well. Hope you have enjoyed seeing how easy it is to use the Ansible modules for Dell VxRail to automate operations using the VxRail API. Thanks for watching!